Oh my god. Oh my god. What's up, guys? Welcome to Let's Fish episode 3. Alright, today we're going to be frog fishing this little area right here. Hopefully we can get a bit. It's currently 2 p.m. I've already caught two on a frog, so they should be biting. I'm using a Japanese reel, don't know the name, KVD 7.4 medium heavy, 65 pound braid, and a Spro frog. Let's get it. So really with a frog, I mean, you just throw it wherever. If you think there's a fish there, throw. That's my favorite thing about them, is it don't matter where you throw. If they get the whole thing in their mouth, you're probably gonna catch them. Now this stuff over here looks real froggy. Real froggy. See, I just throw over the line. Don't even care. Sometimes you do get hung up. You just knock it off. Start fishing again. But the worst thing that could happen is for it to get wrapped around something. Then you'll be in trouble. Hopefully we can catch one in here. I don't see why we couldn't. It's about 2 feet deep. Alright, now before I work all of that, I'm gonna work these logs out here. All I'm gonna do is bring the frog by the log, wind in, and bring the frog by the log. But as hot as it is today, they should be on some little bit of cover. Either under the grass or under these logs. Don't know. But we will find out. Oh, that one ate it funny. He like went up on the log and ate it. Let's see if we can get him again. Because he wanted it, but he couldn't get it in his mouth on that log. We're stuck on a board. Well, we're not stuck. The braid's stuck. Darn. So I'm going to hang around and cast this way. Control the motor on 5. You know, I tell y'all, y'all can put the frog anywhere, and here I am, huh? But what it is, that's not like a regular tree, that's like a 2x4. And the braid went into one of the little grooves. There we go. Alright. Let me slow my roll real quick. There we go. Freaking choked it too. 1.5 pounder. Let's get another one. That's about the size of the one that bit first, so I believe we got him. A long cast way back there. Just seen one swirl. We'll throw it him next. One I seen swirls swirled over there. This is why braid is good for two things: casting long ways and getting a fish in. Figured he'd be right there. That might be a gar. Don't want to catch one of them. Alright, let's check this along. We'll come back through to this other log. As close as the other one hit to the boat, I don't think they care right now. Leave it there for a second. All right. Really, all I'm doing is just a little constant pop. I mean, you can pop, pop, pause. It's just let the fish tell you what they want. But since I've already caught three, I'm doing the constant pop. Pretty much gonna stick with that right now. I'm gonna use this log right here as an anchor so I can not be blowing around as much. I just seen something hit to the left of the frog. I'll wind in, I'm gonna try to get it back there. Or over there. Make some shad come up. Alright, let's try to get it back in that one spot. Alright. Now we really just gonna pick apart everything we can. So hopefully we find another one. Please. Oh no. jackass. In a real situation, I'd be picking up the Ned rig and throwing it in now. But, I've got a backlash right there. Try to get it on him again. Not exactly where I want, but we'll fish our cast. Been a good cast, but my line got wrapped around, so really we're gonna work the same area now. There we go. Let's see if he'll bite again. He bit kind of like a pretty good one, but he didn't choke it. All right. Oh, the sun is blazing. Alright, let's get that one one more swing. See if he'll bite again. If not, we'll go check out this grass line over there. Nope, well, guess he's not gonna bite again. Weed my way through these stumps. Alright, let's flip this stuff. Come on, braid. There we go. No. All right, let's try it again. All looking under the water, there should be some in this grass. I'm gonna go straight down the line of it. And we'll try to pick it apart as we go through it. I don't know how much y'all can see because the sun is directly where we're fishing. Just throwing this little shady point right here. It's not really a point, but the grass kind of makes a point. Just hit somebody's tent. Let's give it a swirl all the way in here. You never know. I know that sun going away feels good. Looking at the sun, looking at the sun. Well, to be honest, I wasn't really expecting a hit, but it happened. He really didn't seem to be that big, though. Playing boomerang with the tree. Well, we're going to go back here as far as we can, at least. Jesus. I could see a bunch of backlashes today. I don't know what that is in the water right there, but I know that's a rope. It's like a pad or something. Go ahead and fish our way out of here. I'll probably like when you hit a stump, because you ain't paying attention. Y'all get to see all kinds of fish today. All right, we're going to work these trees one more time. And that's going to be the end of the video. Actually a pretty good one in a short amount of time. I'm glad I hit record. Oh my God, that was a good one. That was a good one. A really good one. That was probably at least a four. That's one thing I like about Spro. It has like an anti-water pocket. dogs fighting. I think I just jerked it out of his mouth. Ay, ay, ay. Yep, sure did. I suck it, froggy. There we go. Been trying to get you through them two logs here for the last four casts. Thank you. Jesus. Oh my God. Alright guys, that's where I'm going to end the video. I hope you liked it, and if you did, hit the subscribe button. Leave a comment down below what you want to see me do, and let's fish fold. Hit the like button for me, and I'll see you next time. Yee yee!